Duke Franz of Bavaria opens an exhibition in Munich. Crown Princess Victoria of Sweden attends a concert in Stockholm. Queen Margrethe II of Denmark continues her summer cruise aboard the royal yacht Denimbrog. And Queen Rania of Jordan celebrates her 53rd birthday in Amman. All this and much more coming up next on your Royal Daily News. Good afternoon, everyone. I hope you're doing well. And happy Friday. My name is Alexandra, and this is your Royal Daily News for September 1st, 2023. Yesterday, Her Majesty Queen Rania of Jordan celebrated her 53rd birthday in Amman with family and friends. In her social media post, Her Majesty the Queen said, quote, "I thank my lucky stars for each and every one of you, Your Majesty, my family, and all the wonderful Jordanians out there. You have made me feel truly special," end quote. Born Rania Al-Yassin to Mr. Faisal Al-Yassin and Mrs. Ilham Al-Yassin in Kuwait City in 1970. After receiving her BA in Business Administration from the American University in Cairo, Egypt, Rania moved to Amman, Jordan in 1991. While living in Amman, she met a then His Royal Highness Prince Abdullah Al-Hussein of Jordan at a dinner party in 1993. On June 10, 1993, the couple were married at Sahran Palace. Today, Her Majesty the Queen is a proud mom of four, an advocate for women and youth, and works hard to improve the lives of Jordanians by supporting efforts to create opportunities for their advancement. On Wednesday, Her Majesty the Queen visited Mrs. Faril Kofahi's home base kitchen in the town of Khawar in the Irbid Governorate. According to a press release, the purpose of the visit was to, quote, "support and highlight economic empowerment opportunities for women," end quote. Upon her arrival, Her Majesty the Queen was warmly welcomed by Mrs. Kofahi and her husband, Ahmed. During the visit, Her Majesty the Queen learned how Mrs. Kofahi began her business, the expansion over the years, and her future vision for the business. Mrs. Kofahi's kitchen currently employs 10 women, some of whom are Syrian refugees, trained in making traditional Jordanian dishes by Mrs. Kofahi herself. During her visit, Her Majesty the Queen also spoke to the women working with Mrs. Kofahi, who shared their experiences and the impact their work has had on improving their livelihoods. Her Majesty the Queen also offered Mrs. Kofahi financial support to help expand the kitchen and employ a larger number of community men and women. Afterwards, the Queen joined the women in preparing makmoura, a popular Jordanian dish, and viewed some of the women's homemade products and other items. In celebration of Her Majesty the Queen's birthday, Mrs. Kofahi and her team offered the Queen a home-baked cake and thanked her for her continued support and encouragement. This afternoon in Fontvieille, Their Serene Highnesses Prince Albert II and Princess Charlene of Monaco officially launched TV Monaco. According to a press release, TV Monaco is 100% owned by the Monegasque government. Quote, "Revenue will come from advertising and from selling the shows it produces. The budget for the content for the first 3 months will be 15 million euros, after which there will be a budget set for 2024, end quote. The channel will include live shows and sports coverage, and then recorded shows for the rest of the time. The shows it produces will initially be all unscripted, but it has the intention to add scripted shows in about 12 to 18 months' time. There will be a particular emphasis on shows about the protection of the environment, naturally. Earlier this week in Larvoto, His Serene Highness Prince Albert II of Monaco arrived at the Nouveau Musée National de Monaco to view the exhibition entitled Santo Sospir by Brazilian artist and photographer Mr. Mauro Restif. This afternoon, Their Majesties King Willem Alexander and Queen Maxima of the Netherlands hosted a luncheon at Paleis Noordeinde in Den Haag for individuals who have distinguished themselves through a special achievement. According to RVD, the 26 guests recently received an award or other distinction for their achievements in various sectors such as arts and culture, media journalism, science, sports, and business. On Thursday, their Majesties carried out a regional visit to Gelderland Valley in the province of, well, Gelderland. According to RVD, the purpose of the visit was to learn more about the, quote, recent transformations the region is undergoing. The Gelderland Valley, consisting of peat and sandy soils, has grown into a leading food valley. End quote. Oh, that's nice. On Wednesday, His Majesty the King received letters of credence from newly appointed ambassadors to the Kingdom of the Netherlands at Palais Nordeinde. The newly appointed ambassadors are from the Swiss Confederation, the Republic of El Salvador, and the State of Libya. Meanwhile, Her Majesty Queen Maxima of the Netherlands, as patron of the Rania Funds, spent the day in Rotterdam, where she met with representatives, volunteers, and participants of the Recovery Close Together for Mental Health program. According to a press release, Recovery Close Together for Mental Health is a new program that offers psychologically vulnerable individuals room to work on their own recovery process. Quote, for example, when people need it close to home, they can use a self-management or recovery initiative with the aim of rejoining society. Experts and volunteers play an important role in this, end quote. During the visit, Her Majesty the Queen met with the founders of Recovery Close, Together for Mental Health, as well as with volunteers and supporters of the program. Her Majesty Queen Margrethe II of Denmark continued her annual summer cruise aboard the royal yacht Dannebrog this afternoon with a visit to Fredericia Municipality. Upon her arrival, Her Majesty the Queen was warmly welcomed by the mayor of Fredericia Municipality, Mr. Steen Rist. That really is his name. Several local government representatives and hundreds of local residents. Thereafter, Her Majesty the Queen and Mayor Rist arrived at the Old Town Hall, where they were warmly welcomed by the Municipal Director of Fredericia, Mr. Thomas Yap. After a lovely reception at the Town Hall with City Council members, Her Majesty the Queen visited a local primary school, attended an official luncheon held in her honor at the Cultural Barracks, visited the High Synergy Hydrogen Production Factory, visited the Fredericia Musical Theater, toured the new district known as Canal City, and hosted a reception on board the royal yacht Dannebrog in the port of Fredericia. Meanwhile, the Danish royal court announced that Her Majesty the Queen, along with Her Royal Highness Crown Princess Mary of Denmark and His Excellency Count Felix of Monpezat, will attend the premiere of Erengard, The Art of Seduction, at Moltke's Palace in Copenhagen on September 6th at 7 p.m. As I mentioned several weeks ago, Her Majesty the Queen created the costumes and set design for the Netflix film, which you can learn more about in the link above, and is based on the novel Erengard by Karen Blixen. Erengard, The Art of Seduction, directed by Mr. Billy August, will premiere on Netflix on September 14th, 2023. Meanwhile, His Royal Highness Prince Joachim of Denmark began his new job as a defense attaché at the Danish Embassy in Washington, D.C. this morning. Naturally, several Danish journalists woke up bright and early to catch the Queen's second son as he arrived at work. As if he wasn't nervous enough, they decided to ask him a bunch of questions before he went in. I'm sure his boss was thrilled. So one of the journalists asked, "How was the move?" The prince replied, quote, "Princess Marie feels like a fish in water," end quote, meaning that she feels at ease in the States. She lived here, actually, for several years. Prince Joachim went on to say that it has taken time for him and his children to adjust, stating, quote, "It is not easy to move continents. Paris was our second home ground, and Europe is Europe. We know that. This is something else entirely. We have had some challenges and still have plenty to look after in terms of moving in, but the children started school on Monday, and they are delighted. They find it exciting and have already made new friends," end quote. Prince Joachim's contract as a defense attaché, which will cover not only the United States but Canada as well at the Danish embassy, is for 3 years with the possibility of an extension. According to the director of the DI Danish Defense and Security Industries Association, Mr. Joachim Finkelman, the prince's position comes at a time when, quote, defense is significantly more important than it has been in decades. Prince Joachim is the right person to help Danish companies well on their way to further exports beyond the currently estimated more than 4 billion Danish krone. Of this, half to the USA alone. The embassies play a decisive role in terms of opening doors for Danish companies and creating networks as well as frameworks for meeting foreign buyers. The fact that Joachim is also a prince is of great importance. It creates attention and attracts the right people. Prince Joachim is a 3-in-1 solution. He is an extremely skilled diplomat and also has great insight into defense through his education and military rank. At the same time, his cultural background is absolutely crucial when creating networks and opening doors. End quote. Last evening in Stockholm, Her Royal Highness Crown Princess Victoria of Sweden attended the opening of the 2023 Baltic Sea Festival held at the Birdvaldhallen. And I'm pretty sure I mispronounced that, but that's okay. Moving on. The Baltic Sea Festival is one of Europe's biggest and most important cultural music festivals, featuring the best artists, orchestras, and conductors from the Baltic region. And finally, last evening in Munich, His Royal Highness Duke Franz of Bavaria and his longtime partner, Mr. Thomas Greinwald, along with their Royal Highnesses Prince Leopold and Princess Ursula of Bavaria, attended the opening of the exhibition entitled Malalada, Georg Baselitz on his 85th birthday, held at the Pinakothek der Moderne. And there you have it. Thank you all so much for joining me this afternoon. I will be back tomorrow on Saturday, September 2nd, with all the latest royal news. Until then, I wish you all a wonderful Friday afternoon and a great weekend. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you won't miss a thing. Okay, again, have a wonderful Friday afternoon and a great weekend, and I will see you all tomorrow. Bye-bye.